So in this video, I want to talk a little bit about anxiety giving you feedback that you might be living an incongruent life. So anxiety is an emotion that is basically designed to let you know when you have some kind of potential threat to your survival. And this could be because your mind is perceiving a potential threat or perceiving that something bad could be happening or about to happen in your external environment. But it can also be about when your brain perceives you have unmet needs. And why is this helpful? Well, because thousands of years ago, when we had unmet needs, what would happen is our brain would let us know, oh my goodness, you're hungry and you don't feel like you can find food. Okay, time to trigger that anxious response. So you get that cortisol rush, that dopamine rush, a little bit of adrenaline, and now you're out doing stuff. You're looking for food. You're going to find something. And so it would empower you historically, you know, whether it was food, whether it was a lack of safety that you were perceiving, it would empower you to go out and get those needs met. Now, in the present reality that we live in today, obviously the circumstances are quite a bit different. Now what happens is when we have unmet needs as a general rule, then we're more likely to experience anxiety anyways, because this is our subconscious mind communicating to us that we are essentially out of alignment and something's not quite right. And that anxious response is there to support and serve us the vast majority of the time. Now, we must identify where this is taking place and why we are feeling this way so that we can correct this unconscious pattern at the root level. So take a look at your life. Where are you living in a way that you wouldn't necessarily choose if you had ultimate freedom and sovereignty over your life and your circumstances? Why are you living this way? Is it because, you know, you want to go get that career and be an entrepreneur the way you've always wanted to, but you know, your parents are telling you to stay in school, people's opinions, you know, you're afraid of them because, you know, what if you fail and then people judge you? Is it because of some kind of pressure from somewhere else in your external environment? Is it because you don't believe in yourself enough? Look at your life and assess, where might I be living incongruently and why am I living this way? And when you can source that, now you actually have freedom to start creating change. And ask yourself this question too. What does your life look like in 10 years if you haven't changed and actually started to live your life intentionally and in alignment with what you truly desire so that you can meet those unmet needs? What happens if you don't do that? And what you can then begin doing now, and this will actually help your brain create some kind of relief because it will perceive that the needs are starting to get met and will be met over time. Just like if your brain, you know, you think of survival times and your brain perceives that you're going to have food and safety, even if it's a little bit of food, but you know that you're going to get a little bit of food every day, your brain will start to relax, you know, hundreds of thousands of years ago, if you were in a space where you were foraging or you were forced to sort of like look for food and hunt it down, right? Once you know that there's some kind of food coming in, you'll start to feel like you can relax. Same thing. Once you start to feel like you can take incremental steps towards meeting your big needs to get into alignment, you can start to finally feel a sense of relief. So start looking at where you're living incongruently, why, what can happen 10 years from now if you haven't created change in this area, and then provide yourself with tiny steps and strategies that you can take every day, even if they're this small, just to meet that need and to start getting incongruent with what truly matters to you and what you're truly passionate about. And as a result, you will see some of your anxiety begin to diminish.